Last week, we looked at AND, OR, and NOT. These three logic gates are going to be the basis of what we are doing today. Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching episode 3 of Logic Components. Hello and welcome back to Logic Components. Now, last week we looked at AND, OR, and NOT. Now, what we're going to do today is we're going to actually look at some variants of the AND and the OR gate, some of them actually involving the NOT gate. So let's start off right away with something a little simpler. Let's take a look at the NAND gate. Now, you realize that when you're looking at something like the AND gate or the OR gate, that the name actually makes some amount of sense. It actually tells you something about what the gate does. But NAND isn't a word, so what does it do? You see, in fact, the word NAND is a contraction of NOT and AND. In fact, NAND stands for NOT AND. So, at this point, you could probably guess what a NAND gate actually does. In fact, a NAND gate is exactly like an AND gate, but you're gonna have to invert the output. The symbol actually looks like this. Note that it looks exactly like the AND gate symbol, with the exception of this little circle at the end. This circle, in fact, actually represents an inversion. And at any point of time in the future, when you see any form of diagram that actually has this little circle, what this means is you take the expected output and you invert that. So this should give you an intuitive explanation of why the AND gate and NAND gate symbols look so similar with that tiny little difference. Anyway, let's move on to the truth table. Well, you should not have too much difficulty in actually writing out the truth table. On the right, 0 and 0 is supposed to give you 0 if this was an AND gate. Therefore, you want to actually invert the output is actually 1. Same deal for 0, 1 and 1, 0. Since the output is normally supposed to be 0, we're going to flip it around and write them as 1. For 1 and 1 as input, the output would normally be 1. Therefore, for a NAND gate, the output is 0. So let's move on to the NOR gate. Well, if you understand the whole concept behind a NAND gate, the NOR gate should be no problem. It is simply NOT OR. Similarly, the symbol is exactly the same, but with a little circle at the end. And the truth table is simply an inversion of the OR truth table. 0 and 0 will normally give you 0. Therefore, you're gonna have to write 1 in the output column. For everything else, the output, which is normally 1, will get inverted to 0. So alright, that is all well and good. This is extremely intuitive and I didn't really have to explain it that much to you, I'm sure. So let's move on to something slightly more complicated. Let us now take a look at the XOR gate. Now, before I even say anything, you should probably be able to infer that XOR gate is some kind of extension to the OR gate. But where does the difference actually happen? Now, XOR actually stands for exclusive OR, and the truth table looks something like this. Compared to the OR truth table, you realize that the difference is only in the last row. That is exactly what the exclusive bit refers to. In the OR gate, as long as any one of the two inputs are true, your output will be true. This condition is pretty loose in the sense that even if both inputs are true, the output will still be true. For the XOR gate, we actually tighten this condition. The XOR gate specifies that exactly one of the inputs has to be true before the output is true. And therefore, now, for the last column, it no longer fits the requirement, and as a result, its output is false. That is the exclusive OR gate, and a symbol looks something like this. So, that's all well and good. Let us now actually move on to look at our last gate of the day, the XNOR gate. So, using all the information I've given you in this episode, I'm pretty sure you can figure out what the XNOR gate is. It is simply an inversion of the XOR gate. So, given the truth table of the XOR gate, we can easily construct the truth table of the XNOR gate by simply inverting all the contents of the last column. And there you have it, just a very quick episode to, well, essentially introduce the rest of the logic gates to you. Once you actually know and understand all the different logic gates, we can actually then move on to put all these gates together, and as a result, create something that is able to make intelligent decisions based on a certain set of input to give you a certain set of output. But that will be for the next episode. That's all I have for you today. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, you're watching 0612 TV. Hello, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, remember that I appreciate every like, favorite, and comment you give me. If you'd like to see more from me in the future, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And for more updates outside of YouTube, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at 0612TV. Once again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.